I've been busking my whole life, and I love it. But everywhere I go, it's been this constant game to see how long I can get away with making art for free that's accessible to people, the public, the people who might not ever step foot in a gallery or read a poem otherwise. When I arrived in Washington Square Park for the first time, it felt like a haven. It felt like a breath of fresh air because the community of artists was so entrenched that there wasn't that question. You knew you were going to be able to make art there. And then this last time when I came, the bubble burst.
So another two people got arrested today. We don't have a lot of information, but they apparently just got ripped out of nowhere.
The cat and mouse game was back on, and something in me kind of snapped. And I went, I need to do something to make a statement that I support art, that I support public art, free art that is accessible, that is for people, in places that they can come to without having to pay anything. Not even because of Washington Square Park, but because everywhere I go, buskers are seen as some sort of social pariah. And so I sat down in the exact spot where the Rangers are trying to remove artists from the park, and I started writing the longest English poem of the 21st century.
It's a thing of wonder and curiosity as they sort of happen upon it and they see this just big billowing mass of poetry that it seems almost like a living thing in the wind, how it'll chase after someone or run away from someone trying to grab it. And I love that. I love that it sparks a clear light and a shimmer in people's eyes as they bend over and get into all sorts of positions so that they can leaf through just this pile of poetry and read it is wonderful to see people interact in that way with what I am actively making.
Writing this poem in public in the park means that it has been collaborative with the people that have been reading it. It has so many artifacts of humanity, like the bike tread from the person who ran over it, and one of my friends who's a drug dealer nearly beat the crap out of him if he didn't bike away fast enough. I didn't care, but he did. It has, you know, all the markations of like oil that has been left from someone's fingertip, because not only have they been impacted by the poem, but the poem has been impacted by them, and that's what busking is. It is a collaborative effort with whoever is on the street that day. It's not a silver screen, it is a wide open street. It is an asphalt road, and it is just humans existing there. These are my people, and this is what I do, and I want it to not be illegal. Let us make art, dammit! There is a culture behind it that isn't in a lot of places. There's a history behind it where people have been selling art and tchotchkes and poorly done paintings and well done paintings for literal generations. Jack Kerouac, back in the 1950s, wrote a poem about it, and he was heckling a bunch of them. He was like, who are these people with their berets who believe in themselves? You know what? I'm one of those people, sans beret, but I'm close some days, who believe in myself. We, if you really trace it back, come from the line of bards and minstrels. We help share something special and unique and deeply personal that isn't created in some magic factory that has millions of dollars behind it, but is created by someone who lives right next to you, but who believes that art is worth sharing and worth making. And that's exactly what the poem says. It's a lot of words that circle around the idea of oral tradition and communal art, that we are becoming who we are by the stories that we tell, that we are informed entirely by those points of human connection that come largely from art.
This guy right here, I park by him pretty regularly. Let me check, make sure I'm backed up far enough. Construction boy took my favorite spot. Now I'm an artist. So this is the last day I'm bringing out the poem. 240 feet now, which is gratuitous.
My third Kickstarter.
I get more and more nervous every day that it's just gonna get horrifically destroyed. It's gonna sail into the fountain. Some dude is gonna come and rip it just because he wants to. Either way, fate's fate, you know?
I mean, immediately, what's so striking is just like the imagery of it, right? It's like a pile of paper, so who's not gonna like come up and start asking questions? And then as you come close, you start getting more information about what's going on. And you see, I noticed that sign, the longest poem ever. And I realized this was all like manuscript. This is all one long poem.
Interesting, I'm gonna have to keep a close eye on it.
There's a pear sticker on here somewhere, which means that this poem is technically $1.92 per pound. It's a Bartlett. What happens if you make a mistake? I'm like, then you have a mistake in your poem. And they never know how to respond. These people aren't used to accepting mistakes as just being a part of it.